If you are new, subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to receive regular notifications about my videos regarding job updates or computer science topic that I make. Hello guys, I am Parinita and welcome back to my channel to polish your CSE concepts with me. So let's get started. Our today's video is about one of the very important topics of compiler design, that is left factoring. Now before directly going into left factoring, let me tell you what is left factoring and why it is needed. Actually, it is a technique. Okay, so yes, before going into left factoring directly, I want to give you some very important overviews. See, we already know that grammar, here we are talking about the grammar that we are having in compiler design. Okay, so that grammar can basically be divided into two parts in three different ways. See, our grammar can be categorized. Our grammar can be categorized into ambiguous and unambiguous. It can be categorized into two types, that is left recursion and right recursion. Again, it can also be categorized into two divisions, like deterministic and non-deterministic, right? It is very important for you to understand the difference between these two, that what these things actually mean. You must have already visited my earlier videos. In that we have already discussed about ambiguous unambiguous grammar, as well as we have already discussed about left recursion and right recursion grammar. For your convenience, I will give you the link in the description. In case you have not visited them yet, please go and visit that, you will get a clear idea. So my motive here that I wanted to tell you is, we have already seen these two categories. Among these two categories, we have already seen that if any grammar is ambiguous, grammar can be of two types, ambiguous and unambiguous. If any grammar is ambiguous, that is of no use. Why? Because we have already seen that most of the parsers, top down and bottom up parsers, most of the parsers cannot parse ambiguous grammar. So in between ambiguous and unambiguous grammar, we always prefer our grammar to be unambiguous. Fine. So that is an important point. Then with respect to left recursion and right recursion, we have also seen this in our previous video, that if the grammar is left recursion, we don't want it. So what we are doing, if our grammar is left recursion, we are removing that left recursion and then we are using it. For right recursion, that is fine. Fine, we have already seen this thing. Why we don't want ambiguous grammar? Because only operator precedence parser is the only parser that can parse ambiguous grammar. Apart from that, no other parsers can parse ambiguous grammar. So we don't want this. And why we don't want left recursion grammar? Because I have explained you earlier also, left recursion. What do we mean by left recursion? If any grammar is in the type A gives A alpha or beta, anything. If A gives A alpha, like this, any grammar is there, it is known as left recursion. Means what? The variable is calling itself in the very first time. It is calling itself, then again it will call itself. So what the problem will happen here is, the parser will go in infinite loop. In here, what the problem was, that the parsers were not able to parse this ambiguous grammar. And here the problem is, our parser will, top down parsers are mostly, and they will go in infinite loop, because continuously A will go on calling itself. So the parser will go on infinite loop, and obviously we don't want infinite loops, right? That's why left recursion grammar is not preferable. So this is all about these two categories. Again, I will give you the link in description. Go and see these two in detail if you don't know yet what is the difference between them. Then in this video, we are mainly concerned about this categories, that is, grammar can be categorized into two types, that is deterministic and non-deterministic. Now in these two, like I have told, we are not preferring ambiguous grammar, we are not preferring left recursion grammar. Similarly, in this case, we are not preferring non-deterministic grammar. Now what is the main difference between deterministic and non-deterministic? As the name itself indicates, in deterministic grammar, the productions are such that we can easily determine in which production we want to go. But in non-deterministic grammar, the productions are given in such a way that we cannot determine exactly how. For example, I am having A gives alpha beta 1, alpha beta 2, alpha beta 3, and so on. This is the example of non-deterministic grammar. I'm showing you that why non-deterministic grammar are not preferred by the parsers. Because, see, this is the example. What happens here? For example, you want to you want the production alpha, beta, 3. Fine. Now, first of all, you will try to match this first alpha. Here, you will get that, okay, alpha is matched. Then you, first of all, you will match this alpha. Then you are having this beta 1. Then you will compare this. Here we are having beta 3. Now, you, first of all, you will try to match alpha. Alpha is matched, yes. Then you will go to match beta 3. But then you will get that, okay, here you want beta 3. But here you are already having beta 1, which is not matching with beta 3. So what we will do? We will backtrack and then again we will go to check the second one. Here you will try to match alpha. Yes, alpha is matched. Then you will go to match beta 3. But then you will find out that beta 2 is there. Here beta 3 is not there. So yes, alpha is matched, but beta 3 is not matched. So again you will get that, okay, this is not the string that you want. So again you will backtrack and then you will go to the next. Understood what is happening? Again and again you have to backtrack. So this backtracking, obviously this backtracking is not something that we want, that the parsers want, because backtracking takes a lot of extra time. Like it is a wastage of time and efforts of the parser, right? You are getting, obviously. So this is what the problem is there about non-deterministic. So what the problem is? That much time and efforts of the parser is being wasted. And what is the main cause of this of non-determinism? As you can see here, the main cause is repetition of the same prefix. The productions are having the same prefix, and due to this same prefix, the parser is not able to determine that exactly in which production it wants to go. Fine. So this is all about non-deterministic grammar, that non-determinism occurs when we are having same prefixes in the production. And the main problem occurring is backtracking. Again and again we have to backtrack, so it wastes a lot of time, a lot of efforts, which is completely useless. So our main aim is, whenever we are having any non-deterministic grammar, we have to convert it first into deterministic grammar. So that's where our left factoring comes into the picture. So what is left factoring? In one sentence you can say that left factoring is the method that helps us to convert the non-deterministic grammar into the deterministic grammar. Fine, that's it. Now we will see how to do left factoring. It is actually very easy. See, I will directly show you with the help of example. Here I have three examples of the grammar. These grammars are non-deterministic grammar. What we will do is, we will apply the left factoring method and we will convert these non-deterministic grammar into deterministic grammar. Fine. Okay. Now first, A gives AB and ABC. This we are having. This is non-deterministic. Why? Because again we are having same prefix. Means after small a, the parser will get confused where to go and where to not. Fine. So this is non-deterministic grammar. We have to do left factoring. So how the left factoring is done? Whenever we are having like the same prefix, what we will do is, we will take that prefix as common. Means how to apply left factoring here? Here what is the common prefix? Small a. So what we will do is, we will take this small a as common. So it will become a. A gives, this will be as it is. Now small a is common here, we will take a. Then we are having two different things here. One is having capital B and the second production is having BC. So what we will do, instead of these two, we will write a dash. Now a dash is the new variable that we have introduced. So a dash also we have to write. What a dash will be? Whatever is remaining, that is capital B in one production and small BC in another production. That's all about left factoring. It is that easy. Got it? The only thing you have to keep in mind is, whatever common prefix is, we will take that common prefix as common here, and then we will introduce another variable. And in that variable, whatever is left after that common prefix, we have to write that. It is as simple as that. Got it? So what we have done, this is my grammar, that is non-deterministic. I have applied left factoring in this, and this is the new grammar that I got, and this new grammar is a deterministic grammar. Fine. Okay, let's see two more examples, you will get a clear idea. Again here, S gives these three things. Now A, that is fine, but in these two production we can again say that see here that these four terminals and non-terminals, whatever are there, they are a common prefix. So what I can do, as we have done there, we can take it as common. So S gives, I will take I, E, T, S as common, and I will introduce one new variable. Here we have introduced A dash, here we can introduce S dash. This is anything, right? You can take any new variable. So here I have introduced S dash, and then A is alone, and it will remain as it is. Fine. Okay. So my next task is, I have introduced the new variable S dash, and I have to write the production for S dash. So S dash will be, now in first I have taken this whole common, right? Nothing is left. So when there is nothing left, I will write null. Okay. And in the second production, what is left? ES is left. I will write ES as it is. Done. So this I have done. I have converted. Here we are having deterministic grammar. Sorry, non-deterministic grammar. I have converted it into deterministic one. Now E gives B is individual production. I will put it as it is. Fine. That's it. So this is my deterministic grammar. Now here again we can say, see here, small a is common in these three productions, so I can take it as common and S dash, and this B will be as it is. For S dash, if I write, I will get, see what is remaining here, SSBS. So SSBS, what is remaining here, SASB, what is remaining here, BB is remaining here. Fine. Okay. Now again you can see here, capital S is common. Capital S is something that I can still take it as common, because here due to this common prefix capital S, again it is making my grammar non-deterministic. So in the next step, what I can do, this capital S I am taking common, and I am introducing one new variable, that is S double dash. Fine. I am doing the same method again one more time, and this BB will be as it is. Now I have introduced S double dash here, so I have to write the production for S double dash. So it will give me what? In this case SBS, and in this case ASB. Fine. So this is my whole grammar. So if you are again taking this common, you can ignore this. Without writing this, you can do it. Fine. Because directly you can write this thing. So one thing you can do this again. See, I am telling you one more method. Here what we have done, we have taken only A common from these three productions. Without doing this, you could have done one more thing. What we could have done, here we could have taken AS, this whole AS as common. So what we would have got, S gives AS. I am taking this whole AS as common. Fine. And then one new variable S dash. Then these two as it is. A, B, B and B as it is. Now here S dash will give what? After AS, whatever we are having, that SBS, and here ASB. Fine. SBS and ASB. Yes. Is there any non-determinism yet? No, I think it's fine. Okay, so yes, there are multiple ways, but the main thing you should be knowing is just this concept, that whatever there is common prefix, you have to take it as common, and whatever is remaining, you have to write it as a production of a new introduced variable. That's it. And the main important thing to know about left factoring is, what is left factoring? Why we are applying, and why we are converting non-deterministic grammar into deterministic grammar. So I hope you have understood the whole concept here. So guys, that's all about left factoring. If you think that my video was helpful, please share and subscribe the channel, and let me know that you liked it by leaving your like and comment in this video. Thank you so much.